Hare Krishna. So somebody translate or
you want line to line translation?
I ask you, how is that?
Generally what they do, they will hear you and they will translate here at the back.
There, ah, back there,
they
back.
Just will hear it by
okay,
back.
Okay, okay, okay. Okay. Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Hare Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Tarinda. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadada Sri Vasadi Gaura Vrinda. Hare Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadada Sri Vasadi Gaura Tarinda. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe. Govinda Radhe, Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe.
Sarasvati Vyasanta Tojaya Muvirayet
Sri Chaitanya Manovistam Stapitanya Navutade Svayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadatyava Padantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Siutapada Kamalam Sri Guru Vaishnavam Cha Sri Rupam Sagrahatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitantam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vittam Cha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishavanu Sute Devi Pranamani Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Taruvyascha Kripa Sindhuvya Eva Cha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Pardon? Some introduction we need to give.
Introduction? Okay.
Hare Krishna. We welcome all the devotees. And today we are the Purifying Association of Fellow Women's Rupa Raghunath Swami Maharaj. Maharaj is an initiated disciple of Fellow Women's Lokanath Swami Maharaj. And Maharaj is basically from Argentina, from an Italian speaking family. In March 2017, Maharaj received Sannyas initiation from His Holiness Lokanath Swami Maharaj. And Maharaj has been teaching for last many years in Italy. And for last more than 20 years, he has been teaching in India, like Maharashtra, Gujarat, and on all India Padayatra. So we are very fortunate Maharaj has kindly arrived here to bless us. Let us express our gratitude and welcome Maharaj by one time chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare
Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Jai
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So we continue with the lecture of Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 24. I will read a little bit the introduction to follow the argument. This chapter describes the Supreme Personality of Godhead incarnation as a fish, and it also describes the saving of Maharaj Satyavrata from an inundation. The Supreme Personality of Godhead expands Himself by Svamsa, His personal expansion, Vivinamsa, His expansion as the living entity. As stated in Bhagavad Gita 4.8, Paritranaya Sarunam Vinashaya Chaduskritam. The Supreme Personality of Godhead appeared on this planet for the protection of the sadhus, or devotees, and for the destruction of the miscreants, or non-devotees. He especially designed to give protection to the cows, the brahmanas, the demigod, the devotees, and the Vedic system of religion. Thus, he appeared in various forms, sometimes as a fish, sometimes as a boar, sometimes Narasimha Dev, sometimes Vamanadeva, and so on. But in any form of incarnation, although he comes within the atmosphere of the material mood of nature, he is unaffected. This is a sign of his supreme controlling power. Although he comes within the material atmosphere, Maya cannot touch him. Therefore, no material quality can be attributed to him in any degree. Once, at the end of the previous kalpa, a demon named Hayagriva wanted to take the Vedic knowledge away from Lord Brahma at the time of the annihilation. Therefore, the Supreme Personality of Godhead took the incarnation of a fish. At the beginning of the period of Svayambhu Manu and saved the Vedas, during the reign of Chakshusha Manu, there was a king named Satyavrata, who was a great pious ruler. To save him, the Lord appeared as the fish incarnation for a second time. King Satyavrata later became the son of the sun god and was known as Shraddha Deva. He was established as Manu by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To receive the favor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, King Satyavrata engaged in the austerity of subsisting only by drinking water. Once, while performing this austerity on the bank of the Krishnamala River, and offering oblation of water with the palm of his hand, he found a small fish. The fish appealed to the king for protection, asking the king to keep him in a safe place. Although the king did not know that the small fish was the Supreme Personality of Godhead himself, as a king, he gives shelter to the fish and keep it in a water jug. The fish, being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, want to show his potency to King Satyavrata, and thus he immediately expands his body in such a way that he could no longer be kept in the jug of water. The king then put the fish in a big well, but the well was also too small. Then the king put the fish in a lake, but the lake was also unsuitable. Finally, the king put the fish in the sea, but even the sea could not accommodate him. Thus, the king understood that the fish was no one else but the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he requested the Lord to describe his incarnation as a fish. The Personality of Godhead, be pleased with the king, informed him that within a week there would be an inundation throughout the universe, and that the fish incarnation would protect the king along with the rishis, herb, seed, and other living entity in a boat, which would be attached to the fish horn. After saying this, the Lord disappeared. King Satyavrata offered a respectful obeisance to the Supreme Lord and continued to meditate upon him. In the course of that time, annihilation took place, and the king saw a boat coming near. After getting aboard with learned brahmanas and saint person, he offered prayer to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart, and thus he taught Maharaj Satyavrata and the saint person about Vedic knowledge from the core of the heart. King Satyavrata took his next birth a Vivasvat Manu, who is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, Vivasvat Manave Praha. The Sun God spoke to the science of Bhagavad Gita to his son Manu, become of being to this, the son of Vivasvan. This Manu is known as Vivasvat Manu. That is the introduction of this chapter. So now we will go to the text 51. Is okay, 51? We start by the word in Sanskrit, if you want to repeat it. Jana. Janasya. Adisate. Asatim. Gatim. Yaya. Prapadyeta. Duratyayam. Tama. Tvam. Tu. Avyayam. Jnanam, Amogam, Anjasa, Ashiv, excuse me, Prapadyate, Yena, Jana, Nijam, Padam, Jano, Janasya, Dishate, Satim, Gatim, Yaya prapadyeta duratyayam tama. Vantva yayam gyanam amogam manjasa. Prapadyate yena jano nijam padam. Janasya dishate satim gatim. Yaya prapadyeta duratyayam tama. Vanvavyayam gyanam amoham anjasa. Prapadyate yena jano nijam padam. Jano janasya dishate satim gatim. Yaya prapadyeta duratyayam tama. Vanvayayam jnanam amoham manjasa. Prapadyate yena jano nijam padam. Someone want to read?
Jano janasya adishate satim gatim. Prapadyeta duratyayam tamaha. Tvavyayam jnanam amogam anjasa. Prapadyate yena jano nijam padam.
Thank you.
Mataji's? Jana, a person who is not a bona fide guru, an ordinary person. Janasya, of an ordinary person who do not know the goal of life. Adishate, instruct. As a team, impermanent, material, gatim, the goal of life, yaya, by such knowledge, prapadyeta, he surrender, duratyayam, unsurmountable, tama, to ignorance, dvam, your lordship, tu, bet, avyayam, indestructible, gyanam, knowledge, amogam, without material contamination, and jasa, very soon. Prapadyate, achieve. Yena, by such knowledge. Jana, a person. Nijam, his own. Padam, original positions. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. A materialist so-called guru instructs his materialistic disciple about economic development and sense gratification. And because of such instruction, the foolish disciple continue in the materialistic existence of ignorance. But your lordship give knowledge that is eternal, and the intelligent person receiving such knowledge as quickly situated in his original constitutional position. So we read the a materialist so-called guru instruct his materialist disciple about economic development and sense gratification. That is when the aim is material. When the aim is material, everyone look for no dharma, artha, kama. Look at the artha and kama. to get liberation. Mm. And this is the false guru, the instruction of them is with the materialistic aim. Mm. And this is what happened now all in the world, everywhere, because all the government in this moment, all the government of any country, the aim is material aim. So everybody is engaged in production of everything. Why? Because the interesting of every government is to make exportation, and get importation. So like that, the human society, all the human society is engaged in production. But what about Krishna? What you offer to Krishna? And that is for that is the there is no authorities who give instruction to the people, spiritual instruction. There is not. Mm. So a materialistic so-called guru instruct his materialistic disciple about economic development and sense gratification. Mm. Sense gratification is a deceptive sinful activities. Mm. But when there is no aim, a spiritual aim, everybody look for sense gratification. Mm. And by this activity, generate karma in this life, in the next. Mm. Srila Prabhupada say, if you cannot bring your karma, because your karma is very heavy, you can bring your karma here, in your head. And after, when you are tired, you can put your karma here. And when you are tired, you can bring your karma here. But everywhere, if you change here or there, you must to carry your karma. So what is the solution? The solution is to reduce the karma. In a sadhu sangha activities, no? Isha sangha, everybody reduces the karma. This is the point. Even now, if you see from outside what these people do here, no? Nobody do nothing, everybody sitting. No? But even in this situation, no one generate karma. Even if you sleep now. Yeah. So for that is the mind, the body, the world must be engaged in devotional activities. It's not complicated. In reality, it's not complicated. Bhakti yoga is not complicated. The problem is the person are complicated. Yeah. The person follow, no, the shastra follow the mind. And the mind is always complicated. Yeah, always complicated. Mm. Thank you very much. You get another one extra? So Srila Prabhupada and the purport say, the so-called sadhu, the so-called gurus, instruct their disciples for the sake of material profit. Some guru advise that one meditate in such a way that his intelligence will increase in regard to keeping his body fit for sense gratification. Everybody thinks that the aim of the life is to gratify the sense. Everyone thinks that. Because nobody, in India people understand about reincarnation, the most of people. But on the Western, if you speak about reincarnation, then laughing. On the Western people cannot accept the reincarnation. Another guru advised that sex is the ultimate goal of life, and that one should therefore engage in sex to the best of his ability. When Srila Prabhupada started to preach in America, and he speak about limited the sex activities, no illicit sex. One devotee say for Prabhupada, but you cannot speak like that here in America, because in America everybody, the first enjoyment is sex. You cannot do that in America. And Srila Prabhupada say, I cannot change the Shastra to please the American people. Yeah. These are the instructions of foolish gurus. In other words, because of the instruction of foolish guru, one remains perpetually in material existence and suffer its tribulation. But if one is intelligent enough to take instruction from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as enunciated in Bhagavad Gita or the Sankhya philosophy of Kapila Deva, one can very soon attain liberation and be situated in his original position of spiritual life. The word Nijam Padam are significant. The living entity, being part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as the birthright to a position in Vaikuntha Loka, or the spiritual world, where there is no anxiety. Therefore, one should follow the instruction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then, as stated in Bhagavad Gita, Tyaktva deham punarjanma naitimam etisorjuna. After giving up one body, one will return home, back to Godhead. The Lord lives in the spiritual world in his original personality, and a devotee who follows the instruction of the Lord approach him, mam eti. As a spiritual person, such a devotee returns to the personality of Godhead and play and dance with him. That is the ultimate goal of life. When there is no this ultimate goal of life, when the aim is not spiritual, the world becomes a market, bazaar. And everybody is engaged in this activity. Why we go to the school? It's okay, no? To learn, to read, to write, it's okay, but the sophisticated life actually, the modern society, put everyone 15, 20 years in the college, in university, And like that, you become one day a very good Shudra. Yes. Sri Prabhupada won a society, Brahmana society. One time Sri Prabhupada called everybody to say, we will get class in X room. So all the devotees went there. And after Sri Prabhupada looked and asked, where is Yamasundara? So one devotee said, Yamasundara, he say he will stay in the temple to wash the temple, to clean it all. And Srila Prabhupada said, no, call Yamasundara to come here in the class. The temple, anyone can wash the temple. I want a Brahmana society, Prabhupada said. Of course, we cannot say for this young student, stop, don't go anymore to the college, don't go anymore to the university. We cannot preach in this way. But even the student, slow, then must to increase in devotional service. Here is also a voice, no? I think here is also a voice. And this is very important. Sometimes I go to preaching in Maharashtra, is also voice. The young people don't need to stay in the hotel, then stay with devotees, morning time, get all the program, and after prasada, then go to the school. And that is very good because slow, then increase in devotional activities. Then are lucky because there is millions of students don't know anything about Dharma, know anything about Varna Ashram, no, don't know anything. But the modern society obliged everyone to spend 20 years in college and in university. What for? To be engaged in what just now we read. To be engaged in this market, production, no, everything. Production, exportation, importation. And what you will do next life? You will go again to the college. Life become more and more advanced. Kali Yuga, life become more and more sophisticated. Srila Prabhupada say, sophistication of life bring your mind far away from God. This is the problem. Now we take habit, everyone. You, wherever you go, you see everybody like that. This is life. Short life. Yeah, and after 20, 30 years, we'll be more sophisticated. Yeah. So it's urgent to be employed in devotional activities. Srila Prabhupada also, he spent 4 years in the college. And after 4 years, he got the diploma, but he don't took the diploma. He refused. In that time he got instruction, ideas from Mahatma Gandhi. And that time was English people. The system was English people in the system. So in that time, Mahatma Gandhi said, you go to the college, you get diploma and you become puppet of the English people, he said. And Srila Prabhupada catch this instruction. And he don't took the diploma, but he was also in the college. Yeah. We cannot say for everybody, okay, stop to go to the university and college. We cannot say that. But you must our preaching is for them is increasing your devotional activities. On the college we learn something. Yeah, the college we learn English, we learn computation, some history, not much, not necessary, but and now is in India is very good because so many students studying few years, 3-4 years in the college and become devotees. Other way, the future can be very complicated. So the aim must be completely spiritual. Sambandha, avideya, prayojana. On the college, university, nobody teach about. But everybody must to know something. No, I don't tell in India, in the world. Everybody must to know something about Sambandha, avideya, prayojana. At least he must to have this limited knowledge. But it's not like that. Because there is no teachers in the college who told you about Sambandha, avideya, and prayojana. So materialistic people say we have to enjoy now because after we die. And this is the understanding of someone who have the concept the concept material of life. Aham mameti. I am the body. So I have to work for my body and I have to work for the expansion of my body. But what you give for Krishna, this is the point. Here Prabhupada explained something also about Sankhya Yoga. Sankhya Yoga is, by Sankhya Yoga, is the studying of the difference between material energy, spiritual energy. And everybody must to know something about. Everybody must to know who is the origin of this energy. The energetic, and what is the difference between material energy and spiritual energy. Spiritual energy is eternal, but material energy is temporary. Everyone must to know that. Who know that, who don't know that, he work one life only for body and for production of anything. Srila Prabhupada spent one life to explain for us this simple thing, because it's very simple to understand. When you understand the difference between material energy and spiritual energy, you have one really base. And Srila Prabhupada, he worked all life to translate all the Shastra, and even word by word, to show the reality of every concept. After do everything, he say, okay, I do 50%. Now you must do another 50%. And that is what we try to do. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the way of Apavarga, what we read just now. Apavarga, no? Pavarga means material complication, pavarga. And apavarga is the way of liberation. And we are all engaged in this way. So it's not complicated. For those who are a simple person, devotional service is very, very simple. And we get protection of Maya. We are protected because we are in the jail of Durga. And it's difficult to go out. Daivihi eja gunamai mama maya duratyaya mame vaye prapadiante mayam etam tarantiti. By engaging in devotional activities, we can cross very easily this ocean of nescience. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. There is some questions. You want the micro? I have two. I can give you one. Hare Krishna.
Thank you for the wonderful lecture. Maharaj, I have one question about Christianity. There comes a story of Noah's Ark, where Noah puts
maybe better you speak Hindi with everybody, and someone told me.
Christianity. There is a mention of the Noah's Ark. Noah's Ark? Noah?
Ah, yeah.
So he's asking if there's the ark relation between that and this
passage. Uh-huh, yeah. I was not so good devotee of in the Christian society. I took communion and, you know, some instruction on the beginning when we was in the primary school. We got some, one day a week, one day a week in the first school. One day a week, the argument was, the topic was religion. So we get some information, but on the age of 11 or 12 years, we finish the school, and the most of my friends never more put the feet in one church. So I have no much information about the Ark of Noel. But when I read that, I remember this. Because everything, all religion coming from Vedas, is no one separate. If there is no Veda, there is no any religion. All the religion coming from Vedas. Mm. So you see some similar point in one religion and other religion. I saw also the Muslim get some, there is some point similar as Christian also, charity and that and that. Mm. So there is, I cannot tell you about details of the Ark of Noel. But there was one inundation, and Noel, he got the boat, and there was one space of any space was in the cows, the snake, the horse, any space was in the, and like that he saved the. But our philosophy is different. Mm. We get different. We must to follow strictly the Shastra. Strictly. For example, after 100 years, maybe nobody of these people we see anymore. Mm. But if some of them change little bit something, and next century another change, other thing, everybody margea. But the mistake is always there. The problem of Christianity was that. Then next generation, and then change everything. And now it's not anymore a scripture. Actually, Christianity is just etiquette. Mm. I am Christian. I distribute a book, Srila Prabhupada book, during 8 years, every day, door to door, in Europe and also Mauritius and South America, every day door to door, every day door to door. And when reach 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, and I have to chant Gayatri, I always ask people, do you know where is one church? And then say, there in 200 meters, there is one church. So I go there to chant Gayatri, because I know the church is empty. Yeah. So this is my position of Christian. Yeah. Cannot give you much information about the Noel. There is in some book about... He wants to save the space. Mm. Mm. Other question? Grantaram Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sadhu Sangha ki jai, Tai Gaur Premanande, Thank you for your attention. Hare Krishna.